Ground yourself within your physical body. We bring ourselves into this room. I'm going to fill this room with golden light as we raise the vibration in the room, allowing us to do healing here in a safe place where everyone is practicing presence. And it's just mindful of their space throughout this entire class. Welcome back, guys. You guys can open your eyes. And I want you guys to open your little bags. And inside the bags, I have three cards for you. I'm going to guide you through this. And this is basically our little itinerary for the day. It's going to be the sheet that's not laminated. And we're going to go down this list just so you know what's happening next and what we're going to go through. So today, the class is about self-love. So I want to ask you guys, what does self-love mean to you? Really quickly, anybody have a comment? What does self-love mean to you?
Loving yourself.
Just yourself.
Yeah. Being happy.
Being happy with yourself,
okay.
Accepting yourself.
Accepting.
Appreciating your magnificence.
Three-part practice today, and I'm going to teach you guys some amazing techniques that you guys can incorporate into your everyday. We're going to start with a meditation. I'm going to teach you guys active meditation, which is a tool mixing pranic healing and shamanic energy work, and we're going to integrate that into something practical that you can just use every day, all the time, to be mindful, to be in your body, to be conscious, and create a connection with yourself at all times. Loving yourself is actually a daily practice. It's not something that we aim to do. Think about the conceptualization of loving yourself. It's not dressing beautiful, you know, achieving things. It's about an internal communication with the self that you develop throughout your day. So we're going to do this meditation. We're going to do a little mini regression after that. I'm going to take you guys on a little trip inside. We're going to dig deep into any kind of emotional stress that you guys are undergoing. And we're going to dig it up and heal through that. And whatever we learn from that, we're going to use to build our daily practice, which is going to help us during our transformation that we're trying to go through every day. Now, the one thing will be the regression, and then we're going to do a shower exercise. These are all practices that I've been doing for many years. I'm going to share them with you because they have helped me tremendously in my own transformation, and it's something that you guys can incorporate into your life and change it, make it your own. And, you know, this store is a perfect place to do that because Sage talks about natural wellness, connecting with the self, you know, authenticity, and having natural things that are not tainted with any kind of chemicals or anything. So we want to have that same purity with our own mentality and our own communication with our mind and body at all times. That's kind of what we want to incorporate. So the self-love shower exercise will be you connecting with your body every morning before you start your day, creating an exercise that can help you connect with the body. Because we tend to externalize ourselves all the time. We're always running around, thinking about what people are thinking, thinking about what we're doing, what our plans are, what's next, thinking about the past, thinking about the future. So what we need to do is come into the present moment and become more empowerful through our experiences at all times and practice that. Practice that as a daily habit. Through our mind, through what we think, through what we speak, through how we act, through all aspects of ourselves, not just one or the other. There has to be balance and congruency with all our lives, not just a certain part of it. So the next part of it is we're gonna do some EFT tapping. Anybody did tapping before? Yeah? Awesome. So you guys know how wonderful it is to drain your lymphatic system, to raise energy, consciousness. You guys are integrating the practice of the thoughts into action and into the physical body. So that's what we're going to be doing. Wonderful. So how many of you have meditated before? Awesome. What kind of meditation are we doing here? What kind of practices have we done?
Just short meditations. I don't know.
Awesome, great. Great. How often? How often do you meditate, would you say?
Not as often as I would like.
Yeah,
not as often as I would like.
Okay, yeah. Great. But at least you got something. What about you? How's your meditation practice going?
Good. I usually like about 3 to 4 times a week.
Fantastic.
And then you go to a nap. Sometimes it's guided, sometimes it's just a silent meditation.
Okay, beautiful. What about you, sir?
I walk.
You walk. Walking meditation. Very nice. Presence. That's awesome. Wonderful. Okay, guys. Well, good. So the kind of meditation I'm going to teach you, it's advanced meditation. It's called active meditation because I'm going to have you guys visualize. I'm going to guide you through a journey. Okay? So I want you guys to just go with the flow. We're going to let the monkey mind in the back just kind of take a vacation today. We're not going to listen to any kind of restrictions or hesitations. Just allow yourself to relax and go with the flow with what we're going to do. And enjoy it and use your imagination. The imagination is the most powerful tool that we have to create and manifest in our lives. And we have to use that to create who we want to become, what we want to do in our lives, and how we want to have our day. We are in charge of our day. We are in charge of creating our experience. So we have to take a hold of that and stop just going with the flow, you know, take control of what's occurring around us. So let's jump right in since we're on a tight schedule. I want you guys to get really comfortable, but not too comfortable where you're gonna fall asleep on me. Just get really nice and comfortable. You guys can lay down or sit against maybe the little ledges here. Whatever is better for you, feel free to lay down. Yep, just get real comfortable. Okay. Can everybody hear me okay? Is my voice okay? Awesome. So as you guys are getting comfortable, I'm gonna explain something about the energetic body. We have a multidimensional body, which means that our bodies are connected to every part of our physical body. Our organs are through our chakra systems. Are you guys familiar with your chakra systems by chance? Awesome, you guys know a lot. Great, so each chakra system is a very complex system of energy, which is connected to everything. It's connected to our thoughts, and all our information that make us who we are is from these aspects of energy. So through our practice, through our evolution, we have to purify and cleanse those centers so that we can know who we really are. Self-love is a journey in which you have to assist yourself in cleansing, removing all the baggage, any pain, any suffering, any kind of programs, stories of our past that we want to integrate into our daily life now. We have to ask ourselves a question and have a filter so we know whether that serves us now or it no longer serves us. Working with your chakra system is a great way to get started. So we're going to work with the eight chakras. The root chakra at the base of the spine is a red chakra. And then we go up to the sacral chakra, the orange chakra, and the sexual organs. We go up to the yellow chakra in our solar plexus. This is our emotional body. Go up to our heart chakra here in the chest, your throat chakra here in the center of your throat, your center for communication, and your third eye here in the middle of your forehead. Okay, this is your center for intuition. And then you go up to your crown chakra, which is one of the most powerful tools to being in the present moment and creating and manifesting. And with this tool today, it's an acronym that I created called GPAC, grounding, protecting, aligning, creating. And you guys are gonna learn that whole process today. Basically, I want you guys to try to incorporate that in your everyday life. Okay, so before you leave the door in the morning, you realign yourself, you guys are set on all levels, and you go out the door and you're ready to be grounded and centered in whatever you're going to be doing. So the acronym is ground, protect. We're going to visualize a big bubble around us. Now this bubble is kind of like our energetic field. We have an electromagnetic field around our bodies. You guys hear about that, about our electromagnetic field around our body. So this is like our aura that we call it. This is our space, and our space is what we feel from other people. We can feel other people's energy. So what does that mean? That means that we can control our own state of being and our own experience within any activity and around whoever we are. So we have to engage that and use the tools that we are. We're very powerful individuals and creations. We're very powerful. We have to learn to utilize these tools. So when you protect your space, not only are you protecting, and I don't want to say that you need to protect as in be cautious or afraid of anything or protect yourself from harm. What you're doing is that you are being mindful of your space and that you're asking the question about whether you want to allow something into your space. So let's say you go somewhere and someone is having an argument, they have a negative vibration, you know, attitude. And what we tend to do subconsciously is absorb all of that because our subconscious mind is like a sponge. And if we're not mindful of having a filter, we start to absorb everyone's energy, everywhere we are. And at the end of the day, we end up drained, confused, upset, all kinds of things go on, you know, and then we're not conscious. We're like, oh, I don't know why I feel this way. But that's because we didn't take a moment to register with ourselves, check in with ourselves, and see if we really wanted to accept that energy. Okay, so we got to become mindful. That's another tool that we need to use. Aligning. We're going to be aligning the chakras, and I'll guide you through every step of the way. And grounding would be you grounding down to the center of the earth. And I'm going to have you guys visualize the center of the earth. I'm going to have you guys send your energy sphere that you're going to create a connection. Send it down through earth and connect to the center of the earth. What you're doing is you are aligning your vibration to the vibration of the planet earth. Planet Earth, which is nature, which is creation, it's life, is the vibration of love as a vibration of creation. And that's what we want to align, because in order for us to navigate in this material matrix, let's say, you know, within everything that we see, who we interact with, we need to come from a more empowered, grounded, and centered perspective. So we ground and we connect with a stronger vibration from this plane that we're in. Any questions? I know it's a lot. We're going to go through a lot today, but if you have questions, please feel free to ask me. For me, active meditation is not, we're going to turn into monks right now and zone out. I want you guys to communicate with me. If you have trouble visualizing something, tell me, raise your hand, and we'll work through it, because more than likely, another person may have the same question. Okay? Very good. Let's get started. We're going to inhale deeply. Please close your eyes. And exhale. Inhale deeply in through the nose. And as we settle into our meditation, I want you guys to do a quick body scan. Just to reconnect with the physical body, we're going to start with our toes, going up to your ankles, and going up to your calves, our presence back into our hard-working physical body that has us running around all day, focusing on expansion and reconnection, going up to your knees, going up to your thighs, allowing yourself to sink in deeper to your seat. Going up to your hips. Inhaling deeply as you allow the oxygen to enter into all parts of your physical body right now, from head to toe. Going up to your stomach area, to your solar plexus. This is the center of emotions, where all our emotions originate here within our muscle memory. I want you to inhale oxygen all the way down to the base of your spine and expand your stomach, and exhale, releasing, allowing yourself to reintegrate within your physical body right now. Reconnect. Going up to your chest, to your lungs. As you inhale, allow the oxygen to expand your lungs all the way down to the base of your spine, cleansing out any stagnant air from today that we forgot to breathe, allowing yourself to breathe deeply. Going up to your neck, down your arms, to the palms of your hand. Taking our presence to our neck, to our head. Bring our focus to our face, and our face is where all our expressions of the day are here, recorded within the muscle memory. As you inhale, allow yourself to release all those fine lines into a more balanced, pure, and natural state of your body. Throughout this meditation, we set the intention of reconnection and loving ourselves, of connecting with this beautiful vessel that we call our body. It allows us to succeed, allows us to create and manifest our lives. Feeling deep gratitude for your physical body as it is right now in perfect harmony. Go a little deeper in our meditation. I want you guys to visualize the center of the earth. What does the center of the earth look like to you? It can be anything that feels real to you. It can be a rock. It could be a ball of lava, a light. Make your visualization as vivid as possible, so that at any moment throughout your day, you can recreate this quickly. I want you guys to visualize now an energetic connection that's going to connect your entire body from head to toe all the way down to the center of the earth as it connects firmly. And what you're doing right now is you're creating your grounding cord. So visualize your energetic cord. It can be anything that feels real to you. It can be a rope. It could be a light, it could be a tunnel, roots of a tree, send your cord all the way down to the center of the earth and connect firmly. And I want you to notice what changes within your body as you connect. What feels different? Feel this connection and allow yourself to recreate it. Easily to reconnect with any time throughout your day. Now that we're grounded to the center of the earth, I want you to visualize a giant bubble all around you. This bubble around you is your protection. It's your aura sphere. It is the energy that surrounds you 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. I want you to look around your bubble, making sure that there aren't any openings here in this space. Look above you, below, to the front, and to the back, side to side, making sure that there aren't any tears or openings within your space. And if there are, just visualize you closing and healing that space so that you are completely floating inside of this bubble. I want you guys to visualize this bubble being made out of something that is completely impenetrable. You can see through it and people can see you, but nothing can get in without your allowing, without your permission. In this space you create, you decide what you want to allow in. And now that you're here, I want you to look around your space, and we're going to kind of go back to any kind of stress and anxiety that you've had during the week, and notice if it's here in this space. We're just going to notice what's here. We're going to start with our root chakra. I want you to visualize the red chakra located at the very base of your spine. And I'm going to have you visualize closing that chakra all the way down to the size of a dime. So visualize shrinking that red chakra all the way down to the size of a dime as we disconnect from any negative aspects of our root chakra. We're going to go up to our second chakra, the orange chakra located in the sacral part of your body. Visualize shrinking this chakra all the way down to the size of a dime as we disconnect from any negative aspects of our sacral chakra. Inhaling deeply and exhaling. Going up to your third chakra, the yellow chakra located in the center of your solar plexus. Visualize closing that yellow chakra all the way down to the size of a dime. Disconnecting from any imbalances within our emotional body. going up to the heart chakra, the green chakra in the center of your chest. I want you to open that chakra as bright as possible. Visualize a green light emitting from the center of your chest in front and in back. We're opening the channels of our inner connection now, going up to our higher self. Going up to the throat chakra, the blue chakra in the center of your throat. Visualize opening that chakra as wide as possible in front and in back as you are emitting a powerful blue light from the center of your throat. You're opening the channels of communication, inner and outer. Going up to your third eye. Visualize in the center of your forehead, open up your chakra in the center of your forehead. You're opening up the channels of intuition. Everybody aligned? Just nod your head. Let me know that you guys are aligned. Perfect. I want you guys to visualize a white screen in front of you, a blank screen. It could be a whiteboard or a white wall. And on this white wall, I want you guys to see a color that represents your highest vibration possible. What color is that? What color are you? What is your highest vibration? The first color that comes up, if it's more than one color, that's okay. You can use both colors or three colors. Yourself to see that color there now. Everybody got their color? Just nod your head. Let me know. Okay, anybody having a hard time seeing a color? You can raise your hand. Alright, great. Everybody's got their creative color. What we're going to do is we're going to align our intention with all aspects of our lives. We're going to go up to our creation, our manifestation, which is our crown chakra located on top of our head. This looks like a pie chart. I'm gonna name out each part, each section of that pie chart, and I want you guys to fill it in with your creative color. We're gonna start with health. Fill that in with this color that represents your highest self, and what we're doing is we're setting the intention that your health is in perfect alignment with your highest vibration. Your intention is so powerful. The next is abundance. Abundance in all aspects of our lives. Fill that in with your creative color. The next is family. May all our relationships with our family be in alignment with our highest vibration possible. The next is relationships. All your relationships be managed and led from your highest vibration possible. The next is career. And the next is love. Our relationship with our loved ones be made from the highest vibration possible. It is important to have this dialogue with yourself, that you ask that all things that come into your life that you focus on and you create are all coming from your highest vibration, and not a subconscious perspective. From the center of the earth, I want you to visualize a powerful golden light coming in from the earth, from the ground, rushing up into your body, into your solar plexus, the center of your body, creating a powerful vortex of healing energy. So from the earth, the old energy comes up and begins to rotate into a vortex. This healing energy is going to come into our body and cleanse and remove any blockage that does not serve us. From the universe, from source, I want you to visualize bringing down a gold energy from the skies, in through the clouds, through the roof of the sky, in through the crown of your head, and connect with the gold earth energy at the center of your body. As you are combining earth and sky, and you are the alchemist that turns these two energies into gold within your body, within this magnificent vessel that you call your body. We're going to utilize these energies to purify and remove all that does not serve us. Visualize 10% or a portion of that going back down to the center of the earth to provide healing for Mother Earth. Send the combination back down. Going back to your solar plexus, rising that gold energy up your spine and out from the top of your head like a fountain of energy. Visualize that gold energy coating the outside of your bubble, healing your illusion, healing your external. Cutting cords with things that does not serve you anymore. Cleansing. Going back to your solar plexus, rising that gold energy up your spine and down the arms from the palms of your hand. I want you to visualize that gold energy filling the inside of your bubble, all around you as you feel this powerful gold energy revolving around your body. You feel it on your skin, on your face, on your legs, on your back, on your chest. And it penetrates the skin, down to your muscles, healing, cleansing, restoring, re-energizing, rejuvenating. Down to the muscles, to the bone, all the way down to the very cellular level of your body, and we transform anything that's not in alignment into white light as we heal and restore. To absorb this healing energy within your body. We're going to go into our second part of our program. As we go back into a moment in time where you feel that you've had the most struggle in your life, something that has impacted and changed your life in the recent past or maybe even in your childhood. I want you guys to think back to that image as if it were a movie that you're watching right now. Think back to a trigger that you recall. It caused you a lot of pain, a lot of suffering, sadness, to feel lonely. Let's take a look at that image of that time. And without connecting to it emotionally, I just want you to watch it as if it's a movie of someone else's life. And I want you to notice yourself here as you are playing this role, interacting with the other person here. Visualize where you were in that moment, who you were interacting with, and what occurred. And what did that make you feel? Take a look at yourself. What are you experiencing? Explore this image of yourself. As you look at yourself, I want you to tap into what was that feeling there that was felt, that emotion. Now that you have this emotion, I want you to think back to the first time where you felt this emotion. When was the first time you felt this exact same interaction? As you see yourself there in that interaction, I want you to investigate and learn about yourself. Visualize that you're going to see yourself there in that interaction, and you're going to cover yourself in a bubble of gold light. Now, what would you give yourself in this moment to shift your perception, to shift what you feel? Do you need more love? Do you need understanding? Do you feel you need to be seen, heard, accepted, cared for? What is missing? And I want you guys to provide that for yourself here within this healing. As you see yourself, surround yourself with a golden light and provide that healing for yourself there. Inhale deeply and exhale. And as you do, I want you to let go of all of this. We're going to clean our bubble. As you have learned something here within this space, I want you to visualize a giant vacuum connecting to the base of your bubble. And we're going to send down all the stress of this week, of this month, of this year, and this regression that we just did, any emotions that were left lingering behind, we send them down to the center of the earth. So visualize cleansing your bubble from top to bottom, cleansing all of these images, all of this stress, sending it down to the center of the earth. Now I want you to think back to a moment where you were the happiest in your life. One of the happiest moments in your life where you are filled with joy, with love, with excitement. Visualize that image now. And I want you to tap into that pure joy, that pure happiness that you felt in this moment. And bring that into your face, and from the solar plexus, I want you guys to feel that as if it was a white light, and it's going to grow and grow and grow until you are completely surrounded by this magnificently powerful feeling of joy and abundance. From the universe, visualize a golden light coming down, and as it comes into the inside of your bubble, it begins to rain inside of you, and you are covered from top to bottom with this warm golden light as it absorbs into your skin, transforming any darkness into light, providing you with healing, with nourishment. And as you absorb this, I want you to repeat in your mind, I am worthy. I am loved. I am a powerful creator. I am joy. I am the master of my body and my mind. We're going to start with the root chakra. I want you to visualize that red chakra opening back up into a balanced state. So just open that red chakra back up so that it is at the width of your body. Turn that red chakra on. Going up to your second chakra, the orange chakra in the sacral part of your body, visualize opening that chakra back up into a balanced state, right above the first one. Inhaling deeply and exhaling. Going up to your third chakra, the yellow chakra in the sacral part of your body, visualize opening that chakra back up into a balanced state. Going up to your heart chakra, the green chakra, we're going to close that chakra back into a balanced state. As you align your chakras up your spine, you are realigning your perception and balancing emotions, thoughts, feelings, and actions. Going up to your throat chakra, the blue light, visualize closing that chakra back up into a balanced state. Going up to your third eye, visualize closing that chakra back into a balanced state. So all the chakras are up your spine in a beautiful, perfect column, a rainbow column. We're going to go up to our crown chakra. So I want you guys to blast your creative color that you picked, your highest vibration, as bright as possible at your crown. And I want you to be very cautious of this visual because you're going to maintain this visual for the next 24 hours. We're going to send that light up to the ninth chakra. So visualize that there's a little light bulb on top of your crown and it's going to turn on. And the 10th chakra, you're going to turn that on. And the 11th chakra. So you have a string of lights going up, connecting you up to source, to your highest self. As you embody that person now. And as you visualize your grounding cord connecting you down to the center of the earth and maintain the bubble around you of protection that you have created and become acquainted with, I want you guys to come back into the room. And as you open your eyes, I want you to maintain the visual of the grounding cord of your bubble around you and of your creation above you, your crown chakra. Inhale deeply and exhale. And you can open your eyes when you're ready. Was it too long, was it? Not too bad, okay. All right, guys, I'm gonna go around the room and I wanna know about your grounding cord. I wanna know what your grounding cord is made out of, what your connection to the grounding cord is and what it's made out of, what is your protective circle made out of, what color it is, and what your higher self is. So I'm gonna start with Isabella. What's your grounding, what's the center of the earth look like to you?
It kind of looks like a kind of like a tornado, sort of when you do it in a water bottle.
Okay.
But it's black and blue.
Interesting.
And then my grounding cord is always sort of like a cord, but of like thunder, like electricity
thunder.
Or something.
Okay, awesome.
Or lightning, sorry.
Awesome. Yeah. And what is your bubble made out of, and what color is it?
It's kind of like out of crystal, and it's always like greens and whites. And
beautiful. And your creative color?
Great.
Green. Awesome. Kyle, what about you? Did we lose Kyle? Kyle's... Welcome back, Kyle. Alright. Quick question. What is your grounding cord look like? And what's the center of the earth look like to you?
Just like anchoring into the ground.
Anchoring into the ground. Okay, great. And what's your bubble made out of? Like an aura?
It's transparent.
Okay. And your creative color?
Forest green.
Forest green. Very good. What about you? What's your grounding cord look like?
Nautical rope.
Like a nautical rope. Okay, that's your cord. Awesome. What does the center of the earth look like to you?
Like lava.
Like a lava, like a core. Okay. And your bubble around you?
It's also just clear.
Like a clear bubble. And your creation?
Yeah.
Green. Very good. How about you?
My cord is just like a big beam of light connected to the side.
Okay.
And it was also the bottom of the bottle.
Okay.
And then my bubble was more like a green and gold kind of bubble that I made.
Okay.
So that I can only allow what I want to have it.
Yeah.
It's also like a gold color.
Okay.
And then
your creation? Fantastic. Beautiful. What about you, Nicola? What does the center of the earth look like to you?
To me, it was like a big ball.
A big ball?
Yeah.
Okay. What color was it?
Grayish.
Gray. Okay. And your connection?
It's kind of like a big cord.
Like a cord?
Yeah.
Okay. And what does your bubble around you look like?
It's like
a glass. Like a glass. Okay. Very good. Awesome. And your creative color? Navy blue, very nice.
The center of the earth is like black, like a hard ball.
Uh-huh.
It's like energy.
Yeah.
The cord was like a fiery column, like the sky. Like
nice.
Fiery.
Very grounded.
And
your bubble around you?
My bubble was like It's kind of like glass, but it's like thicker than glass.
Okay, that's awesome. It could be like the Pope's cage or
kind
something.
Of like glasses that are like really thick.
Yeah. Like an aquarium thing or something. Okay, perfect. Whatever feels real to you. And what is your creative color made out of?
Dark purple.
Okay.
And my where I got this light is strongly white.
Fantastic.
And my bubble was like plexiglass, clear plexiglass.
Perfect.
And my color was a lightish green purple.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Wonderful. What about you?
No. My earth just looks like dirt to me.
Dirt? Okay. Yeah. Like a water bubble, like a thicker.
Yeah.
Okay. Awesome. Monica, what about you?
Mine, the center of the earth for me is sort of like a pink crystal.
Ooh, okay.
And I usually connect with a tube that goes all the way down. And I actually can see crystals out there.
Wow, you get creative. Very nice.
Beautiful. The bubble is clear.
Uh-huh.
Sort of like a soap bubble, but very strong.
Very strong, okay.
And my color is sort of like a pinkish, sort of like a salmon color.
Yeah.
That's like
beautiful. What about you, sir?
My grounding cord is like a red fire pole going down to a center that's kind of an orange red liquid light.
Okay.
And bubbles kind of like the gold envelope.
Like a gold envelope. Okay, fantastic. And your creative color?
Blue.
Blue. Fantastic. Thank you. What about you, Ms?
The center of my earth was a streams of different types of soil, but they were luminescent.
Wow, beautiful.
It's beautiful.
Wow.
And my bubble is a very crystal.
A crystal too, okay.
Yeah.
Like,
and my color was indigo.
Indigo, ooh, fantastic. And what was your connection? What connected you down to the streams of energy?
I think it was light.
Just light, okay, fantastic. So you guys, these visualizations are very important. You know, even though they seem like just silly visualizations, what we're doing is we're using our imagination and our intention to align our vibration and sending that where we want it to go. We want to be grounded, we want to be centered within our body. Because we're multidimensional bodies, because we have different bodies, which are basically reflected from what our chakras, our chakra system, each one has its own body. And all of those we have to integrate and bring them into the present moment. Otherwise, we are dispersed within our creation and who we are. So these help us to align ourselves, aligning all our chakras, because when you have your chakras out of alignment, your perception is going to be skewed. Your perception is coming from where that disalignment is coming from. For example, the root chakra represents fear. It's the negative aspect. Everything has a yin and a yang in the universe. Absolutely everything has a white, a black to create a balance. Within your chakra system, there is also that need to create a balance. The negative aspect of your root chakra would be, let's say, the fear. And what that causes us is to have a perception of not being safe, for example. And those perceptions hide into all our psyche subconsciously. So anytime we're interacting with someone, maybe we're insecure, maybe we feel judged, all of those things play, and that is because we have our chakras out of alignment. So as we work with purifying each one of the chakras, we realign ourselves into a more pure perspective, a more balanced perspective. So that's the point of why we want to have to align chakras. Your protective circle, visualizing at all times, so even right now, you visualize having that energetic space. So when you're talking to someone, you are conscious of what your space is and what you're going to allow, and you are respectful and mindful of another person's space, okay? And that should happen everywhere, no matter where you are. If you are shopping in a grocery store, out dancing somewhere, you know, or at work, you know, whatever you're doing, it's important to maintain and own your space, okay? So, the second part of our exercise was regarding the regression. So let's talk a little bit about that. Were you able to go back to a point in your life that was a stressing moment? And so who would be like to be the first one to talk about that? And I want you guys to tell me, what was the emotion that you identified in that regression? Who would like to start first?
Isabel?
I think for me, it was just like the emotion was more like confusion, like not being able to understand what emotion between what I was feeling at that time.
Okay.
Like the distinguishment between what I was feeling and what I felt like I needed to be feeling in order to get through that emotion.
Okay.
So basically, like, it was the best description would be the confusion.
The confusion.
Yeah.
And that confusion, at what point did you have the confusion? Was it because of a old set of programs, of ideas that you thought you were supposed to have, and it was imposed onto what you authentically felt that was causing the confusion?
Kind of. It's just that it was something like way, way in the past. So for me, it was sort of, I felt more confused than anything.
Mm-hmm.
And I think that's when I feel myself, like I've always not liked that feeling of being confused.
Okay.
And so when I was confused, I was also battling with, like, should I be mad? Should I be sad? Should I be worried? Like, I didn't know what feeling it was, so it just kind of piled on. So it was amplified.
I see.
Of, like, what kind of emotion I should have taken on to get over that
moment. Right. Okay. So when you did that regression, what was the emotion that you would have needed at that time to help and ease or disallow that confusion?
Just to block. Like, just to be, block. Like, you know, just to completely block it, and then so that I could feel my own emotions and beyond that.
Feel your own emotions.
Yeah.
So reconnect with yourself so you can see what is your true authenticity in that interaction, and then be able to act from that.
Yeah.
Okay, great. And so my question to you is, where in your life today are you able to integrate that information? Where can you maybe be more authentic within what you feel and accept that emotion, you know, throughout your entire day, whatever you're doing?
Yeah. I mean, I think that the situation is very distinct.
Mm-hmm.
So I do that every day. And I think that from that experience, that actually kind of made me do that on a daily basis. Because it was kind of like the point where I learned to disconnect, basically put the bubble up and just be in my own bubble, feeling what I need to feel.
Right.
And protecting myself from the situation.
Protecting yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, great. All right, wonderful. So within the journey of self-love, it's important to dive into these aspects of ourselves, because from that, that's the gold. That's what we need to dig up so we can learn about ourselves and understand how we can transform the negative aspects of ourselves. And in truth, I don't want you to think that there is a negative and a right thing to be, because there isn't. What we're doing with this information is merging those two dualities within ourselves. Because the more we learn about where that negativity originated from, the more we can accept, heal, and merge them, and, you know, become more congruent with who we actually are, who we really are, without all those false perceptions. So anybody else want to share what they went through? Sometimes those topics are hard to get into, but I want you guys to take the moment of your day, just any time that you feel a trigger throughout your day, I want you to ask yourself, what's being triggered? What is being triggered? And through that, I want you to undo it and kind of dive into that and see where it originates. And maybe when you go home later in the day, you know, meditate and silence your mind. You can run this energy like we did today and think back of the first time where you had that feeling and work on it. understand where you're coming from in that interaction and what were you missing at that moment. So your trigger means that you lacked something. How can you heal that perception of yourself within that moment to become complete, to feel safe, to feel whole? You know, and so that's how we have to continue our work constantly. Yeah. So I want you guys to go in your little bags and take out this self-love reconnection paper. And I'm going to read this really quickly. So for me, in my personal journey, I have gone through tremendous different levels of transformation, you could say. And as we go through our own transformation, we realize that we, you know, sometimes we need to understand who we actually are without the perceptions of what our family wants us to be, what the society wants us to be, who we are just in our own selves. What we want to do is, a lot of times we allow our surroundings to identify who we are. So what we need to do is create and dig up all the things that have been hidden, all the true aspects of ourselves, okay? And something that I have found really useful is doing affirmations every morning in the mirror, doing mirror work with yourself and reconnecting with yourself. Anybody has done mirror work here before? Monica? You too, yeah. How did you feel?
Right.
It's fantastic, right? It's amazing, you don't realize how hard it is at the beginning to look at yourself in the mirror and to accept yourself fully when there's a disalignment with your own acceptance of yourself. So it's important to do that mirror work to see what is there and how you can develop from that. So working with affirmations, I have found that what we're lacking is a true connection with ourselves. And how do we create that? We have to make it a habit, a daily habit of nurturing and connecting and communicating with ourselves. Because what do we tend to do? We wake up in the morning, we roll out of bed, jump into the shower, quickly get dressed, maybe stuff ourselves with something and run out the door to our busy day. And so we have to respect ourselves. We have to allow the space for us to create our day. We have to set an intention. We have to connect with ourselves and see what we're feeling. I bet you, how many times a day do you ask yourself, you know, how am I doing? Anybody ask themselves that? How am I doing right now? You ask yourself that?
Yeah.
Awesome. That's fantastic. So that's something that we need to do because a lot of us don't. And we're disconnected. We don't know how we're doing. We just kind of go with the flow and whatever happens, happens. So a great way for you guys to start doing this is in the morning when you jump into the shower. You know, I know we have busy lives, but the first thing you do, you open your eyes. Allow yourself some time to meditate, even if it's just 10 minutes for you to realign yourself, connect with yourself, see what you feel, any emotions that were brought up from the day before, let them go, clean yourself up energetically. Energetic hygiene is super important, you guys. Just the way you brush your teeth, comb your hair, take a shower, you need to do energetic hygiene. You need to detox at the end of the day from your heavy day, everything that you absorb from people around you. And cleanse your space. Visualize the bubble around you, visualize cleaning your space, and reset yourself, okay? You can re-energize yourself, rejuvenate, regenerate by using earth energy, visualize gold energy coming into your body, filling you up and healing you. These are tools that you have to use, and ancient cultures have been using this. We're now bringing all that knowledge into today. All this beautiful science of these natural products are all, you know, ancient knowledge that we've known for centuries, and now we're just waking up to this knowledge again. We have to connect with that, reconnect with ourselves. So when you take a shower, which is another, everybody takes a shower every day, you know, at least once, or maybe you skip a day. So when you do take a shower, it's a wonderful opportunity for you to be with yourself, with your physical body, with accept, love, and create a practice of love for yourself. So when you get into the shower, you can use the soaps, and we have these amazing products, like these beautiful soaps today. But when you jump into the shower, where's my little soap? Here it is. You know, I want you guys to set the intention that you're going to be using this practice, this ceremony, because water is a conduit of energy, okay? So when we go into water, our intention is magnified, okay? It's magnified, and water is grounding. We are connecting our energy with earth. This water is an element of the earth. It's very powerful, and as we cleanse our body, we can use the soap with the intention of cleansing and reconnecting with your body. So as you do that, I want you guys to go down through these affirmations, which you can customize. You can look online affirmations, and if none of these quite fit what you need, through your own practice, you can develop your own affirmations, whatever you feel you need. For example, this one here, I put some great ones that are quite useful. The first one is, I love myself. You would be surprised how many people have never said that to themselves. How many people have said that to themselves here? Raise the hands. Very good. All right. I like this class. Maybe you didn't say it. Huh? Okay. Well, you're going to start from today. So when you say that, it's almost like you open up a new dialogue with yourself. Because having the ability and the strength and the love to say that, to love yourself, is a transformation even when it's with itself. Meaning it and setting that intention for your own healing. I am pure beauty and perfection. Some of us, we feel that we are not perfect within who we are because of our society, because of our families, what we live in. We constantly feel that we have to transform ourselves to fit into a little mold of what perfection means. So we have to create our own molds, and it has to be whatever we are, as we are. We are perfect essences of vibration of the universe. Okay? I am worthy. Feeling worthy for who you are, for loving yourself, for choosing the things that are beneficial to you, and only if you think you're worthy enough are you going to make those choices. So that has to be a dialogue that you make with yourself constantly, okay? I'm worthy to eat properly, to drink water, to calm myself, to communicate what I need, my needs, you know, to find my success, to find what I need for the next step. I am the master of my body and my mind. Learning to communicate with your body and setting the intention of how you want to heal, how you want to become, being conscious of that. We go throughout our day driving through the car, listening to music, looking at the beautiful things around us, but do we connect with ourselves enough to know how we are feeling at all times instead of being sponges to our surroundings? Walking around absorbing all the garbage that's being said to us. You know, just the way we want to have purified products, we have to have a purified mind and have a filter for those things. So you stay grounded and you own your space. You're grounded within your space. You own your reality. You own your creation and how you want to welcome things and create from who you are. So my every step is one of courage. And I am authentic, true, and expressive. So all of these kind of touch a different aspect of ourselves. And as you take a shower, I want you guys to get your little soaps. You're going to set your intention for love. This is you loving yourself. And as you wash your body, visualize the gold water as if it were gold energy, healing, covering you, any kind of imbalances, physical imbalances, any anxiety, any pain, any hate, any kind of thing that you're working on, allow yourself to cleanse that. Cleanse that and your seven bodies, your entire essence, okay? And as you do that, say your affirmations. It's such a quick and easy way to connect with yourself in the morning. Just as you're washing yourself, I love myself, I am worthy, I am whole, I am complete, I'm the master of my body. And just that practice alone, if you try that for at least 21 days, it shifts your perception. And you are much more grounded. By the time you get out of the shower, you get your clothes on, everything changes, your perception of everything around you. So I want you guys to do that. And at the end, you can set the intention for your day. You know, do we often set the intention for our day? What are we working on? Only a person that's working on themselves is going to take the time to set a clear intention for their day. A lot of times we just go with the flow and do whatever. It's more important to set an intention. So for your own personal advancement, what are you working on? Are you working on speaking your truth more? Are you working on being more authentic? Are you working on taking care of yourself, of eating better, drinking water? Simple things. It doesn't have to be something lavish. Just very simple things that you can do. Okay? And your intention for your day, what are you creating? Are you wanting to be more successful, expanding, going, taking your career to the next step? Are you going to go buy that book and study what you need for the next step? You know, what are those things? Be clear create your success. It's not, you don't just flow into a river and it just shows up. You have to put effort and intention in creating everything in your life. Okay? So that's that practice. Any questions about this, guys? And you guys get soaps inside your bags thanks to wonderful Sage. Thank you, Sage. Okay, guys, let's go to the next one. So what do I do after that? So this is what I do personally. Before, well, I do this actually when I'm driving. I don't know if that's such a good idea, and I don't want to tell you guys to do that. But EFT tapping is a wonderful way to work with our lymphatic system, our energetic system, and draining and cleansing it. So the way we're cleansing all parts of our bodies, we're cleansing our mind through meditation, our intention, our energetic space through meditation. In the shower, we're cleansing our body, and we are realigning, we're reconnecting with our body. This the same way we are now triggering our lymphatic system, our energy, our body. We're going to be touching points of our body in order to release tension and drain any of that accumulated emotions that are stuck, because that's how our body works. Our body is memory. It absorbs all the memory of our day, what we think, what we speak, what we eat. All the choices we make are there in every cell of our body. So what we do with EFT tapping, we're going to go through this one time. I want you guys to take a look at your little sheets. Has anyone done EFT tapping before? Some of you, yes, wonderful. This is a great, great way, really easy to re-energize your body. Any intention that you have, you can create by having your own affirmations, okay? So for this one, we're going to focus on self-love. So guys, we're going to have some beautiful essential oils for you to do your tapping, because this allows you aromatherapy and self-connection.
Okay, so each oil rollerball, you guys can select one. There's big ones in each kit, and they're sitting on their corresponding crystal. So I'm just going to read to you what each crystal is going to mean. So Tantra is the one at the end on the jade, and it's the mantra on the actual bottle that is like, open my heart to pure authentic love and release all fear of vulnerability. Jade encourages us to connect with our truest, most authentic selves. A good luck stone to many symbolizes both harmony and wisdom. So if anyone feels like they need that. Yoga is on the purple, it's on the amethyst. The mantra on that one is, I feel grounded and centered as I connect with the smooth rhythm of my breath. The high vibrational frequency of this stone helps us feel more mindful and grounded.
Alright,
Shanti is on the white marble. I choose to bring peace and harmony outside myself by acting mindfully towards others. It symbolizes unity, serenity, encouraging us to see the bigger picture and recognize our interconnectedness.
Anybody need that one? Yeah?
Goddess is on the rose quartz. I relax into the gentle power of my feminine being and let all that is good flow through me. This inspires awareness for the love of beauty in yourself and in others, energy of compassion, peace, tenderness, nourishment, and comfort. Ananda is the tiger's eye. I see the truth clearly, and I rediscover my strength through the release of all judgment towards others and myself. Helps us feel balanced and see the truth.
Start with our head, guys. I want you guys to read these out loud as you guys tap, okay? No, you know, you can also do both if you have the time. You can do both sides of your face. But either way, if you can just do one, it still drains your entire lymphatic system, okay? As long as you guys are doing it within this cycle. All right, so let's start at the top of the head, guys. Let's repeat. I accept myself even with all my imperfections.
I accept myself even with all my imperfections.
The eyebrow, right over here. I embrace all aspects of myself, including my shadows.
I embrace all aspects of myself, including my shadows.
To the side of the eye, I am worthy.
I am worthy.
Going to the side of the eye. Side of the eye. There you go, you got it. All right, under eye, I am the master of my body and my mind. Guys, with intention, come on. Under the nose, I am loving, loved, and lovable.
I am loving, loved, and lovable.
And allow yourself to give it a nice, firm, tap, what you're doing is you're stimulating this point of your body. This is the energetic nerve. This is a powerful area where you can release all the toxins here within this part of your body, okay? Going down to your chin, I love myself unconditionally.
I love myself unconditionally.
There you go, just tap that. Down to your collarbone, just right here in the middle. I give myself the freedom to be my authentic self.
Give myself the freedom to be my authentic self.
And underarm, you can do it under here using the same arm, just right. It's 4 inches under the armpit, basically. And what you're saying is, I am safe and exactly where I need to be.
I'm safe and exactly where I need to be.
Inhaling and exhaling, maintaining your breath, going back up to the top. I accept myself. Okay, inhale deeply. How many of you guys feel the rush? Do you guys feel the buzzing? Yes? No?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys are gonna feel that minimum 3 times. I do it seven rounds, so 7 times doing this. You're creating a circuit of energy. You are releasing the tension, draining your lymphatic system, energizing yourself, and you can customize this to whatever you need, even with fear, with any kind of anxieties, with any kinds of things that you're going through. Like, for example, if you feel that you're not worthy enough in some kind of situation, run it through, create your own practice and customize it to what you need. But this tapping is very powerful. It's wonderful for your health. Okay? Tell you about my own practice. So usually when I wake up in the morning, I will meditate for at least an hour in bed. And then I will jump out of bed, jump into the shower, do my self-love, and then usually I'll do the tapping. I always start my day with a tall glass of lemon water, which is amazing to create alkaline in your body, okay? Right in the morning, you alkalize your body, getting rid of all the toxins, allowing you to cleanse and detoxify. I am huge on juicing. I juice every single day, a green juice. My juicer ready, my veggies ready to go, and you know, you gotta incorporate a lot of greens. I personally have a plant-based diet. Doesn't necessarily mean you all need a plant-based diet, but it's important to create a rainbow in your diet as best as you can. You know, incorporate as many vegetables and fruits as you can, drinking a lot of water, 8 glasses of water a day, minimally. You know, we have to make this connection with our mind, our body, make it a practice in everything we do. You know, we only have a certain set of hours a day. How many of those hours can we do something to nourish ourselves, to grow, you know, to change our lives? And these tiny little changes really create a ripple effect in everything, you know, till we age, till we grow older. And aside from that, eating really healthy, you know, how many of you guys do juicing? Yeah, so try it, you know, try it. And even if you don't have time to do it at home, you guys can go out and buy yourself a smoothie everywhere. They have juicing everywhere nowadays. But it's so great to reset the body and absorb those vitamins that go straight into your bloodstream. You know, you get all those vitamins and all those goodies right away. Now today, I believe we have a wonderful set of tonic waters, is that right?
Yes.
Can you tell us a little bit about those, Isabel?
Crystal is a tonic water champion.
Oh, thank you so much for coming. I'm so happy to brought you on this journey. Thank you.
Yeah.